Welcome to Chatterbox Quilts. I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst. Today I'd like to show you how to make a slice and insert block. So this is what it looks like. So you're using probably a patterned background with plain strips or vice versa. You want something where you're going to see the strips against your background fabric. So keep that in mind when you're choosing fabric. I start off with a 9.5 inch unfinished block. So I'll finish at 9 inches. You can start with whatever size block you want. This will work for any size block. And it's quite easy to do, but I have some little tips to show you to make it easy to create them and to try and get your strips to line up as best they can when they go across other strips. Okay, that sounds a bit confusing. Just watch and learn as we go along. So this is a good technique to use with, say, layer cakes and jelly rolls. Okay, so if you have layer cakes, 10 inch strips, or 10 inch squares, I should say, and jelly rolls, 2.5 inch strips, you can always cut these down to different widths. That would make it really easy because they're already pre-cut for you. So that's something you can use your layer cakes and jelly rolls for as well. So the first thing I want to do, I'm just going to move that out of the way so you can see what I'm working with, is to cut a 9.5 inch, in my case, or whatever size you want to start with, square of background fabric. So I'm using a patterned background fabric and plain strips in my example. And then I want to have a couple of strips. So it doesn't matter what width these are. I think this one's probably around maybe 2 inches, something like that. This is a good use of scrap fabrics too, right? What you want to make sure is your strip extends above and below the square. Okay, it doesn't have to be a lot, like an inch or so is probably fine. You just want to make sure it goes a little bit further. Okay, then comes the fun part. You're going to slice your square. So you're going to slice it on a diagonal. So I'm just going to move over here. And it doesn't really matter, you know, how severe that angle is. It's up to you what you want to do. So I'm going to slice it something like this. And notice I'm not going on the diagonal right across the block. It's not nearly as interesting. So just cut it like that. And now you have two pieces, right? That makes sense. So what I want to do is go to the sewing machine and I want to stitch this on, remembering to keep it a little bit longer past the edge of my background block. And I'm just going to go to the sewing machine. I'm going to stitch that with a regular 1/4 inch seam allowance. And then I'll meet you back here and show you the next step. So I've stitched on the red onto 1/2 of the background square. So this is what it looks like. Notice it's still extending over the top. Don't worry about that. And I want to press it. Okay, I'm not too fussed about which side I'm pressing it to, but let's just give it a press here. Okay. And then I can cut off. We're going to trim this all up eventually, but I can just cut off some of this excess on this side anyway. We don't need that. Okay, so let's move over to my cutting mat here for the next part because I have to join these parts up now, right? So you may think that's pretty easy and it's not rocket science, but there's a little bit of a trick. And so actually I got this from Jackie Gehring does this, and it should line up really well if you follow this method. Okay, the reason I'm using my cutting mat is that I can line this up along the top. I'm concerned with getting the top edges matched up evenly after it's all stitched together. So if the top ones are okay, everything else should kind of fall into place, right? So what I'm concerned about is if I'm not careful, I might end up with something like this, okay, which is not good, right? So you want to have something like this. And this is why I'm using my cutting mat, because I'll be able to check in a minute once I'm finished pinning. I'm going to show you how to pin this so it's going to come together really well. Okay, so move this over a little bit, and I'm going to take my pin and I'm going to just put it in, hopefully relatively evenly. Okay, but I'm not too concerned about this part of the pin. I want to see where the pin is coming to the edge of that red fabric. Okay, so I want to make sure that this fabric is going to join up with this part of the pin here. Okay, this is going to drive me nuts if I don't get this straight. Okay, that's pretty good. So you can see how the pin's going along that line on the cutting mat, okay? So what I want to do is I want to flip this over, and I want to line up, obviously, along the edges between the background fabric and the red, and I want to make sure that this part of the background block is sticking up about 1/4 inch above where the pin is. So you can kind of eyeball it, and we're going to check this in a few minutes. But if you really want to, I can take my ruler and line it up. So that looks pretty good. That's my quarter inch mark there. So that's pretty good. Okay. Then what I want to do is I want to take pins and I want to take them parallel to my edge, not perpendicular like we usually do, but parallel about a quarter of an inch in. So let me get some pins that you can actually see that have colored heads where you can actually see them. And just kind of eyeball this, because what we want to do is we want to check and see if this is going to, when I flip it over, if it's going to be okay or not, if it's going to line up along that top and look good the way I want it to. Okay. For some reason I'm having issues with pinning today. There, that's a little bit better. Okay, so that's good enough. You don't have to pin the whole thing down. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you want to see if when I pull it over, if it's going to be roughly lined up along the top there. So I want it to kind of be up here. So some of these ones I may have in a little bit tighter than they should be at the bottom, but you can see when I fold it over there that it looks about right. Okay. This is lining up along the top. It's not skewed. It's not way far down. So that looks pretty good to me. So I want to keep that there. Now, if you want to, you want to make sure that that fabric doesn't shift or anything. So you do want to keep it pinned. If those parallel pins are going to bother you when you go to stitch, just turn around, put them in perpendicular like you usually would do. Okay, then we're going to go back to the sewing machine. Again, I'm going to do a quarter inch seam allowance stitch down there, and we'll come back and iron it, and you'll see what it looks like with the first piece of fabric inserted. Okay, I'll meet you back here in a couple minutes. So I've sewn the rest of the background block on. This is what it looks like. Okay, keep your fingers crossed. We're going to move it over. And it looks pretty good, I think. Okay, you're going to trim this block up at the end, but you just don't want to have, you know, 2 or 3 inches that you're going to have to trim off. So just press that over, pressing it towards the background block. Okay, that looks pretty good. So now I want to add another strip. So I want to add the blue one. So let's go back because we're going to do some more slicing. So now I want the blue one to cross the red one. Okay, not like an XO. Probably something a bit different. Okay. So what I want to do is I want to move this. I could go way over there. Let's do something like about like that. Okay. So just going to line my ruler up on a diagonal and we're going to slice again. So fun, isn't it? Okay. So you got again, two pieces, right? And again, we have a strip that we want to put in. We want to make sure it's extending a little bit past that background fabric again. So I'm going to go to the sewing machine. I'm going to sew that with a quarter inch seam allowance. I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you how to get the reds to line up across your block. Okay, I'll be back in a couple minutes. Now I've added the blue strip. Okay, and I need to press that to one side. And then I'm going to show you how we're going to add the rest of the background fabric and the red, because now you want the red to match up here. Okay, that's what we want to do. So I'm going to zoom the camera in a little more so you can see the details of that when I show you the pinning. So let me just do that. I've zoomed the camera a little closer so you can see a little bit better. So this time we want to make sure that the red is going to line up on either side. Again, if you don't want to do that and you want to have it off kilter, you can, but you're going to have to start off with a lot bigger block because you're going to be doing a lot of trimming when it comes to the final stages. So in this case, I want to try and line it up as best I can. So let me show you how to do that. What you want to do is you want to take one of your pins and I want to mark where that would come across the blue. So roughly like that. Of course, it might help if I have a pin that's pretty straight. Okay, let's try that. Okay, so right about there on the blue, I'm going to put the pin in. Okay, so that's just an indicator of where I want to line things up on the background block in the red. So then, move this over a bit. What I want to do is we're going to line up obviously along the edge of the blue as best we can, right? Because that's where we're going to be stitching. So you want to match those edges, but you want to match the seam allowance here to where that pin is. So you can see I'm way off on this, okay? So you want to go up here. And you want to match that seam allowance to where the pin is there, okay? And like we did before, you're going to want to go along and you want to check this first before you actually stitch it down, right? So let's kind of go along and pin about a quarter of an inch in along that background fabric with the red in it. Let's get one more in here. Maybe a little bit more of a quite in there. But anyway, okay, so now we want to take it across. We want to see what we're doing here. So if it isn't quite the way you want it, like this is just a tad high, okay, you can see at the top as well, you can move it down a bit. So there is some shifting that goes on, and that's fine because, ouch, that's not fine, because you are not actually seam ripping at this point in time, right? You're just adjusting with your pin. So watch those pins, okay? They hurt. Okay, let's pin again. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, perfect, right? But you want to try and get it as good as you can. Extra there. Okay, so we're gonna turn it over. Okay, that's looking a little bit better this time, I think. Okay, so I'm gonna keep these in here. Again, I can switch them and put them in perpendicular if I'd like, and I'm gonna go to the sewing machine and I'm gonna stitch that down, and we'll come back and see what the final block looks like. Okay, I finished the final seam, and we're gonna flip it over and see how we did. Let's see how we did here. What do you think? I think that looks pretty darn good. Okay, so I want to press it here. Just press it all down. All right, so I've got the two blocks. This one, of course, I will trim off all the excess and trim it down and make sure it's 9.5 inches, but I've got the two blocks here now that you can see, and they look pretty cool. So try the slice and insert method, and if you have any questions about it, be sure to send me an email at kim@chatterboxquilts.com. And I'd like to invite you into my private Chatterbox Quilts Facebook group. You can find us at www.chatterboxquilts.com/FB group. That's FB group. I hope you join us there.